Hi, I'm Gauri, and I have successfully survived 16 years in a world where 736 million people who have the same gender identity as mine have experienced sexual and/or physical violence at least once in their lifetime. Sounds a bit disturbing, doesn't it? The people in power eventually tried to do something about it though. Recognizing these and a ton of other problems, the UN marked 25th November of every year as International Day for Elimination of Violence Against Women. Women's rights activists have observed 25th November as a day against gender-based violence since 1981. This date was selected to honor the Mirabal sisters, three political activists from the Dominican Republic who were brutally murdered in 1960 by order of the country's ruler, Rafael Trujillo. On 28th December 1993, the General Assembly adopted the Declaration on the Elimination of Violence Against Women through Resolution 48/104, paving the path towards eradicating violence against women and girls worldwide. Finally, on 7 February 2000, the General Assembly adopted a Resolution 54/134, officially designating 25th November as the day, and in doing so, inviting other governments, international organizations, as well as NGOs to join together and organize activities designed to raise public awareness of the issue every year on that date. Unfortunately, it has not been enough. Although women and girls account for a far smaller share of total homicides than men, they bear by far the greatest burden of intimate partner family related homicide and intimate partner homicide. Only 2 out of 3 countries have outlawed domestic violence. 37 countries worldwide still exempt rape perpetrators from prosecution if they are married or eventually marry the victim. 49 countries currently have no laws protecting women from domestic violence. It's pretty safe to say we have a long way to go. So this year, on 25th November, let's take an initiative and educate everyone around us.